Wow, there's a crap ton of you. All right, so we got Lindsay, Michael, Caleb, Ryan, Jeff, me, Jack. We're missing two people, though.
X-ray and Vav, Jack.
Huh. Okay. So we're looking for a couple guys. Ray, Gavin, are you guys around here somewhere?
Did somebody
X-ray?
Forget to pick them up again?
Vav? Are y'all here?
It's cool if they're not. We can just go on without them.
Are you dead?
There's a couple. All right. X-Ray and Vav, we need you!
We've seen them. We
need you here right now! I'm scared.
Man,
I'm scared
they're
without
reliable.
Them.
Well, this bit went really well.
The timeliest of Crusaders.
So how are you guys doing?
All right. Where are they? Oh my God, it's X-Ray! Oh, shit! What took you guys so long?
Where was the Batman music?
Wait for you guys to come out. So, yeah, X-Ray and Vav, this is made by Anna, Matt's wife, actually, who did the Captain Dynamic costumes as well. So thank you very much, Anna. She's right here in the front. So, anyway, there you go, our superheroes. All right, so we don't really have anything planned, as per usual for Achievement Hunter. So, I'm assuming we have question mics or something, maybe, do we? I don't know if we do. Yeah, we do. Okay, so if you have questions, go to the mics, and we're going to say stuff.
I have a question first, though. Does anybody have any alcohol on them right now?
Or water?
I mean,
can I borrow an increment of alcohol?
Like, if we cut open a vein on you, would we get some out?
Yeah. That would be weird and incestuous to drink my own. I'll take.
Care package?
Oh, there we go.
Whoa.
Oh,
someone came prepared.
What's in the box?
Our fans are awesome, by the
way.
Is
that a care package of booze?
You just asked a crowd of people for alcohol and was provided with alcohol.
Twist off, not twist off.
It's probably nice and warm, too, just like good beer is.
That's like piss warm, right?
All right, so there is a... God damn, there's so many of you. So we filled this hall, like, with 30 minutes to go.
It's even got his favorite color pink on it.
You guys are the best. All right. So as you guys know, our little website is turning 5 years old in about a few weeks, and we couldn't be here without you guys, so thank you very, very much for this. I mean, we've gone from sort of an offshoot of Rooster Teeth as far as like Red versus Blue, that's what everyone knew, you know, Rooster Teeth for, to now we're filling a whole damn arena by ourselves. So thank you for that.
Way to pat yourself on the back, Jack.
I'm patting all of us in the back. All right, so anyway, should we just jump right into questions? Yeah? All right. Let's do some questions. All right.
Good question.
Let's see, we'll start, okay, there's two things. We'll start on this side over here.
I'm not gonna lie, I can't see that far.
I don't know if you guys have noticed, but Ray is actually wearing two pairs of glasses. Hey!
Good job, Ray.
I just, I love the idea of someone who can't see very well having to run looking through red spirals through a crowd of people. That's pretty funny to me.
I'm pretty low down here, Ray. I don't think you can see me anyways.
Huh?
All right, guys, my question is for Michael, and it is... Do you plan on doing a full play of Dead Space 3?
I think there's actually something that may come out with that. I don't know
Oh, this is an interesting picture here. It's my face, and I'm very green. Yeah. I don't have a plan for Dead Space 3, but there may be some Dead Space 3 coming out.
I'll go ahead and jump in. I think Joel and I are going to be doing a Dead Space 3 playthrough. So the two of us together. Whenever we get some free time, we're going to start working on that.
So now make him do it because he said it.
All right, yeah, over there.
All right. Whoa, hello. What do you guys do besides Achievement Hunter at Rooster Teeth?
Each other.
Awesome.
Huh?
Does Achievement Hunter bring in the Benjamins? Is that all you guys do there?
I bring in the Washingtons.
Yeah, Achievement Hunter is, we all used to have varying responsibilities. Like, I used to make Red versus Blue, and I ran the store. Oh, you guys heard of it. Yeah. It's pretty cool. But as it stands now, this is what all of these idiots do full time. Every once in a while, Ryan will help out with some animation stuff. But that's pretty much it. I guess Lindsay still works on the podcast sometimes. Oh yeah, Gavin films stuff in slow motion too. I forgot about that. How long did you guys work on that?
What made you guys come up with the idea to start Achievement Hunter?
Nothing made us come up with the idea. We had been doing Red vs. Blue and Rooster Teeth and the shorts and everything for about 7 years or so at that point. And Bernie and I were both really into collecting achievements and Gamerscore, and we were always competing. And to that end, we were always scouring the internet looking for guides, usually Game Facts or some shitty guide on YouTube. To try to figure out how to get achievements on stuff we were stuck on. And I remember thinking one day, I wish that there was a decent resource for us to go and get actual help with video games. And I decided that we should be that resource. And then I learned very quickly that we're not good at games. We're just good at being dumb at games. So we stopped trying to be helpful and started trying to be funny.
And then you hired Ray.
Yeah, then we hired Ray. Who was... kind of like an idiot savant. Also kind of just like an idiot. Okay, how about you over there?
Okay, first and foremost, Mark Knott!
Mark Knott!
Okay, just my question is, I have kind of two. First, how did each of y'all come to be a part of Rooster Teeth and Achievement Hunter, and did y'all ever... Did y'all ever imagine doing this for a living?
Why don't you just start there and go across? Work way down. Got it.
I started making community videos for about just for fun, and then 3.5 later, so this is a short version. Jeff hired me, and before that, I was working at like UPS and GameStop and unemployed. So after my unemployment ran out, I'm like, "Hey Jeff, need a job, buddy." It was either that or I get a real job, so thankfully I'm sitting right here in tights, so everything worked out. So I came into the community.
He literally said one day, he said, hey, I'm my unemployment's running out, and I can't game the system any longer, so I need a real job or I have to stop. So I was like, all right. And then he goes, could I have asked that question a year ago and gotten a job? And I was like, yeah, probably.
I started watching Red versus Blue, and I decided that I wanted to become roommates with the orange guy. So it's basically just a really... I wanted to move in with his wife and kid. I didn't think it was creepy. No, I'm actually just a fan, and I started making videos and stuff, and I did Griffball highlights was the first thing I really did, and then went up from there.
Yeah, I was writing for a website about video games, and I met Joel and Bernie at a poker game, and he's like, hey, you should come up with some ideas for us, and I pitched him some ideas, one of which became Forced Enjoyment. And from there, I made friends with Joel and Jeff and the guys, and Jeff had this idea. He's like, hey, let's grab some pizza. And I went and had pizza with Jeff.
Friends.
And
What kind of pizza did you have?
He pitched me the idea for Achievement Hunter. And then like 2 months later, we had the site up and running. So yeah, and I've been there since.
I started Rooster Teeth with Bernie and Gus and Matt. Pretty much.
Boring, pass the mic.
Craigslist.
Yeah!
I got a funny Ryan story too. I actually posted an ad on Craigslist for a video editor, and he got the job, even though I made him go through 3 interviews just to be an asshole, because he was living in Corpus Christi.
Yep.
So I thought that was funny that I had to make him, I kept making him drive up to Austin for these interviews.
With a 1 week old at home.
Yeah, he had a 1 week old kid at home too. Yeah. And the reason you got the job is because his cover letter said, so I always wondered what it would take to get a job at Rooster Teeth. I never thought Craigslist would be the way. And I was like, I'll hire that guy. He's funny.
I have to admit, when I showed up the first day, I was pretty sure that it wasn't going to be Rooster Teeth and I was going to be raped in a back alley.
Classic Ryan.
The jury's still out on that.
That's for your 2-year anniversary.
So, yep, I was hired by an actual job interview process. No.
I guess I just met Jeff Gaming, helped out at conventions for years, and asked nicely.
You got hired because I liked your little brother.
I've been a fan for a while, since I was like, say, season 2 or something like that, but I'd never done anything with the community or anything. And a few years ago, like 2009, I started making YouTube videos. And I guess Bernie, I think, saw one of them like 6 months after it had come out. And Jack ended up going to my YouTube channel and sending me a private message like, hey, this is Jack. I work at Rooster Teeth. And he like left this whole thing. And I was like, oh, shit. And I just like replied to an email. And we went back and forth for like 3 days. And then Rage Quit came out like a week later. And then that was it.
I was actually a fan of shorts before Red vs.
Hi, Lindsay.
Blue, so, yeah, sorry. Right?
Hi.
Hi. Sup? Sup, Ray? I can't actually physically see you, so I was like, what? God? What's happening? Is that what he sounds like? Oh, shit. yeah, I started becoming a fan of shorts, and I went the traditional route that your parents tell you to do, which is fill out application after application for a job after college. And I just found out my friend, Miles, I'm sure you guys have heard of him, he worked at Rooster Teeth. Yeah, so I was like, oh, shit, you work at Rooster Teeth. I like those guys. So I got an internship, started working with live action, and, you know, how could you not love these fucks? So I was like, got an opening for something? I'd love to make shit for you, and here I am. Yeah.
Fuck, was that? That's a lot of people. All right. Yeah, right. Yeah. We gotta stop hiring. All right, yeah.
You, sir.
Congratulations, buddy.
Is that a European wrestling belt? I didn't know they had fake wrestling in other countries.
European champion.
It actually is the European belt.
What does British WWE look like? All good answers.
In the Minecraft Let's Plays, who would you say has killed Gavin more? Michael or Gavin himself?
I don't know. I think it's pretty close, right? What do you think?
I definitely do a lot of damage to me, but recently Ryan's had a little thing for me with his sword.
Recently, Ryan has descended into madness. Like, you guys don't even know the fucking videos that are coming out in, like, the next 3 weeks. This guy has an ending that's gonna blow your fucking head off.
Good time.
Yeah, they're not kidding. We're, it's hard to remember because we're all about to go on vacation, various vacations across the summer, so we won't be around together to play Minecraft. So we're, I think, 7 Let's Plays ahead, or 9 Minecraft Let's Plays ahead. So there's some ridiculous, dumb shit coming up. Yeah, you're welcome.
Someone
Thanks
actually
for watching him.
someone put together a spreadsheet of who detects who the most and like who starts the fights and who wins the fights. I think I'd started the most and lost the most. But I would say Ryan's descent into just
you keep saying I descended into madness.
As soon as that cow walked through your front door, it was like
you're the one that locked him in there.
Ryan's a scary motherfucker. Yeah.
Then he wouldn't move out. What do you want me to do?
And then you added the chicken.
The chicken also moved in and of its own accord. And then there was the sheep. I don't do this. They do it to me. That's a lot of words. I don't know.
All right. Let's go over here.
I was told to get as close to the mic as I can. Hey, guys. I love all y'all. I waited like 6 hours, gave my...
Too close.
Sorry. I gave my fourth row seat to that Asian dude up there. Stand up. Where is he? Yep, there he is. I gave my seat to him to get back here and get close to this mic. Look, I love you guys, and my dream is to finish college and then join you lads up there and be an idiot with you guys. I love you, Ray. Come on.
I love you, Ray.
But... I was talking to one of the smarter guardians outside. He told me everything I had to do to get close to you guys, and I've never done any of that.
Like, you up to the mic closer?
Yes!
Like,
they told me to kiss it.
Man, who gets to use that next?
Look, I've never done any of that stuff he told me to do, but in these next 3 years I'm in college, I'm going to do that shit, and then my name is Dylan Hatcher. I want you guys to remember me, because I want you guys
Steve,
to see me
right?
a lot more from
Steve
now
Jones.
On.
Dylan, all I can say is you bury that hatch, okay?
Well, thank you.
That was
lovely.
Dumb.
You're welcome.
All right, I've been standing around for 6 hours. I got to piss like a motherfucker. I'll see you.
So Dylan's hired, basically.
You want to write that down, Jeff? Jeff. Put that in the company thought book.
Yeah, I'll put that in the company thought book.
I didn't know that microfilm fellatio was a prerequisite, so. I just wanted to.
I think I got the job.
Hey, we brought a thumb drive. Is there any chance we could get a copy of Achievement City?
Come on, Jeff, right?
No. Oh shit, I forgot my gamer tag. I left it at home. All right, cool.
I live with Jeff, and I'm not allowed in Achievement City without him.
It's true.
I will say there is a very good PC rendition of the Achievement Hunter City that is very faithfully upkept. Someone's waving back there. If you look on the Achievement Hunter group for PC Minecraft Achievement City, you can find a fairly good rendition you can download.
Yeah, we played Grand Theft Auto yesterday, and we brought up our own gamer tags on USB sticks. And Jeff was terrified to hand it off to somebody because that's Achievement City in that little thing, and he was giving it to somebody. So he could have run and taken it from us, but he did not, so that's good.
Don't ask him where he keeps it at night.
It's also backed up in triplicate. So.
All right, over here.
Okay. Clean that off. No, I was just going to ask, I met up with some friends from the site, and we got a condo at 6th Street. What is up with 6th Street, man? Okay, we show up on Wednesday, the streets are closed off on Wednesday, and I've never seen so many, like, drunks in my life.
Yeah.
How do you guys deal with this?
It's like Texas.
Welcome to Austin.
Hey, we like... I was...
It's why we live here.
No, I was expecting like Rangers, big old 45, cowboy hat. No. I got...
Go an hour in any direction.
Yeah. This is the least Texas city in Texas, for sure.
Oh my God. Hey, thanks guys.
No problem, thank you. Hello.
Hi. Jack, where's my waffle?
Oh yeah, Jack, you're making waffles, right?
I didn't have time to make 10,000 waffles, I'm sorry.
Nah,
I apologize.
Oh, shit.
I'm the asshole now. I actually have a real question.
Actually, he said 9,000 of those waffles were for him. Oh, you and Dylan should hang out.
Sailor Moon, I get.
Hey, you boys. The name's Harley Quinn. I was just in the.
She commits. I like it.
It.
I see you now.
So the nifty little card pack that came in all of our bags, I noticed that the lovely X-Ray and Gav were on a certain card. So you two, you're my new Mr. J's. Also, to appease all the fans, Ryan, what kind of music does your son listen to?
Bad question.
Please don't anger Ryan.
You will be happy to know that my son is now greater than two and has a very discerning taste in music. It's all terrible and mostly Elmo-based. So yes, the question has been answered. And actually, that was only the fifth time I've heard it at this convention, so you guys have shown great restraint, and I thank you for that.
All right, my first question is directed at Jeff and Caleb, and that is, what is game night?
I actually don't know.
And my second question is, I love you guys. You guys have a really good, y'all work really good together on this. The camera and stuff?
Well together.
Yeah, y'all work well together. And I was just wondering if you guys kind of keep that dynamic off the camera as well.
Do we have the same dynamic off the camera as on the camera?
Right.
Fuck, I don't know. Do we? Sure. Jack says yes. So.
Sure, I guess.
There's the same dynamic for you. Gavin, what do you think?
Yeah. I hate all of them on camera and off camera, so yeah, pretty much.
Well, Gavin and I, we frequent Sixth Street quite often. We go swimmies a lot after work and during lunch sometimes with Lunchtime Bevs and Riot Punch. So I think we do a pretty good job of maintaining that.
I'd say if anything, people are nicer on camera than off camera. Way nicer. All the stuff that gets cut, Jesus.
Get out.
Thank you very much for the scooty, whoever just brought this up. Thanks. Sorry, did someone ask a question too? I wasn't paying attention, I got a scooty.
Okay, my question is for everyone really. How do y'all choose what games you let's play?
I think it's like, whatever we think's gonna be fun, right? Because like the best Let's Plays really are the ones where we're having the most fun. So like if we're having fun playing it, most of the time people are gonna have fun watching it. All right, so like remember when I said we had fun playing
it? I hate
it?
All of you.
Magic the Gathering, not fun playing or watching.
Well, some like Grand Theft Auto, we literally watched the Grand Theft Auto 5 trailer and we're like, why have we never done a Let's Play in Grand Theft Auto 4 and now we've made, what, like probably 15?
Yeah, like 15,
or so.
20 of them.
Yeah, so it's stuff like, sometimes it's as simple as that.
Ryan, how many GTA Let's Plays do we have filmed that haven't come out?
That we have not released yet? I think probably 5.
Really?
Yeah. Some of those may not come out.
They're not all good.
Some of them may get Magic the Gathering'd.
Yeah. And you're welcome for that.
Yes. No, you don't.
No, you don't.
It's 30 minutes of me explaining how to tap mana.
Basically, what happened was, it was me, Ryan, Jeff, and Ray.
Yep.
And none of us knew how to play except for Ryan.
So you knew how to play, don't
you? Well, I slightly knew how to play, but you explained I know how to play Yu-Gi-Oh. You taught us how to play, and then the first thing we did was all three of us killed Ryan in like 2 seconds. So then none of us knew even how to finish, and it took us like an hour to piddle to a fucking end. And you actually say in the audio as we get up, we're like, well, that's not coming out. And then we hit stop.
That's the first time we unanimously were like, yeah, it's not coming out ever. We're done. delete that.
It's not even, it's worse than a fail.
My footage is gone.
No more. We do have a 2-hour Let's Play that's coming out next week that you guys are going to have to suffer through, though.
You're cheering now.
Yeah. You are not going to be happy about it.
What's up, guys? My question, I just want to know if there's a game that y'all really want to do a Let's Play in but haven't got around to, or if not, like, one coming out soon that you're really excited to do a Let's Play in.
Well, we're obviously really, really, really excited for GTA 5. Yeah. Saints Row 4, it's going to have co-op. I don't think it'll have multiplayer, but we're excited about that. I don't know, is there a game that you've always wanted to do a Let's Play in that we haven't? I'd like to do more sports games personally, but people don't really give a shit about them, so I probably won't.
Oh, also?
Like, I think an NBA Let's Play would be really fun, but...
I'm looking forward to doing the Artemis Bridge Simulator.
Oh, yeah, we're going to probably do that at some point.
I say do more sports. I'm a Steelers fan, so...
Oh, okay.
I like you, wherever you are. You're over there somewhere.
Oh.
Bitch, what you know?
Since someone's got to do it, can we have a stupid Gavin story and Achievement Hunter's plans for Destiny?
A stupid Gavin story?
Gavin being stupid. In the Achievement Hunter circle, preferably.
Come on then, let's hear it.
I mean, he's sitting right there. Do you want
to... It's like, where to begin? I honestly, like, Gavin and I meet in the living room every morning at about 9, and then we drive to work, and that's stupid. And then we get to work, and he's stupid. And then we go to lunch and get a sandwich, and he's stupid. And then we go home in the car, and we usually got a happy hour, and he's stupid. And then at happy hour, he's a little extra stupid. And then we repeat the cycle. I don't know. Can you have anybody come up with a dumb Gavin story?
I have a nice Gavin moment from yesterday.
Okay.
So it's the end of the day. Dan, the man, as some of you might know, is here. And so it's the end of the day. And Jeff goes up to Gavin, and he's like, all right, I'm going. And Gavin's like, oh, I'll come. And he's like, all right. And then they leave. And like 5 minutes later, Dan walks in. He's like, where's Gavin? I'm like, oh, he left. He's like, I'm fucking staying with them. And I'm just like, God damn it. So I was like, all right, we're going to leave soon. We can give you a ride. So Lindsay and I give Dan a ride, and we drop him off at Jeff's house. And Dan's like, you know, stranded like in another country. And he's like, can you guys wait till I get in, like before you drive away? So I'm like, all right. So we sit outside, and he knocks on the door for like 3 minutes. And I'm like, fuck, do you see their cars? And Lindsay's like, nope. So he walks into the back, and I call Gavin. I'm like, dude, where are you? Are you home? Or no, I was like, he's like, oh, I left. I'm like, I know, are you at your house? He's like, ah, we're not there. We're downtown. I'm like, dude, I got fucking Dan here. He's like, oh, well, why is he with you? And he just left without him. And then like, we drove him and dropped him off at the fort. And Gavin's like, oh, hey, what's up? It's like, what the fuck were you doing?
I'll be honest. There was a lot of Jack and Cokes yesterday. And I was in the car with Jeff. And I just thought, oops. Sorry, Dan.
And the Destiny plans?
We'll be playing and doing Let's Plays in it and achievement guides. And I mean, it's Bungie. We're keep very on. Excited.
Hi, guys. You recently hired Lindsay and Caleb. And I was wondering if you're going to move out of the office or expand at all, because it's getting kind of crowded in there.
Kind of crowded?
Yeah.
It's pretty fucking crowded. The company is in the process of trying to find a larger facility. When we got the building we're in now, I think we had like, I don't know, like 14 people or something. And now we have like 56. So we grew a lot faster than we anticipated. Oh. And it's things are tight for everybody in the company, not just us. So, but it's hard to find a building that doesn't cost $10 million that's a little seat, you know. I guess we should get something bigger than 56 people.
I kind of hope we don't get a different room, though, because then we miss out all the shots of Ryan on his sweet couch with his setup and his table. And then the Ray shot for any verses or behind the scenes where you have to, like, go like this and I'm next to the wall and I'm like, Ray's face, the whole frame. Yes.
By the way, that couch is really comfortable.
Yeah, it's pretty ridiculous, especially with, like, when Lindsay's filming behind the scenes, because it's, like, packed out the asshole. There's, like, six dudes piled in there, all sweaty. There's, like, fucking
it's,
10...
It's as hot as you
think.
It's
hot. Yeah. There's, like, 10 computers going on. Ray's taking his shirt off. There's all these Xboxes and shit. And she's, like... She's spinning in a circle trying to film the room. Also, if we get a bigger space, fuck you, Ryan. He can't keep the couch. I want the couch back.
What?
Yeah. You're going to be sitting in like a giant office in the middle of the room on a fucking couch still. Time to get a desk.
That couch is actually the third member of Achievement Hunter. So.
Thanks, guys. Are y'all going to ever try to use the Oculus Rift on any games or anything like that?
Do you have one?
No.
We don't either.
I'm looking forward to trying it. I think it's going to be weird trying to take videos of it, though, because it's bifocal. So we'll definitely play with it at some point.
So first off, congratulations to Michael and Lindsay for their engagement.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. It's very sweet
You're
of
welcome.
You.
Oh, hey, real quick, before you continue, that dude right there is JJ. He edits a lot of the videos you watch. He's awesome.
Shout out to JJ.
And finds a way to put a picture of himself in every one of them.
So my question is when are we going to get another World of Warcraft Let's Play or a Defiance Let's Play?
Oh, boy.
We filmed 6 World of Warcraft Let's Plays. We've only released 2. There's a reason for that. I really don't know. Ryan?
The reason for that is Team Lads. That's why there's no World of Warcraft Let's Play.
I think maybe Jeff learned he shouldn't make us play World of Warcraft as punishment because it doesn't turn out for a good video.
It's true. I was mad at him, so I made him play World of Warcraft for a while.
It was like 5... The World of Warcraft Let's Plays, like as long as they are when Ryan has to go through those messes, they're like 3 times longer. Like we film for like 4 hours, like 3 hours, something like that. Yeah. And you got to cut them down like crazy. So it's like 4:30 and Jeff's like, should we film a World of Warcraft? And he's like, nah. And I look at Ray and I'm like, nice, thank God. And Jeff's like, oh. Yeah, no, now we're playing.
Yeah, we're pretty happy.
We
played
till like 6 o'clock,
and
it like he was just like, "You guys having fun? Do you like it? You like it? You like it?" And we're just like,
11 p.m. rolls around. It's like, "Oh, we can go home now. Thanks."
Yeah, we're like, "No, Jeff, this is awful." He's like, "Oh no, this is great. This is great." It was like an hour and a half of just like silent bickering.
And Defiance, yeah, we'd like to. It's on the list. It's just hard to do. I don't know. It's the process of making a Let's Play with 6 people it's kind of ridiculous. And so we can't edit them as fast as we can shoot them. And we've got such a catalog of Let's Plays. I think we probably have, I counted the other day, I think we have like 38 Let's Plays filmed that haven't been released right now. And so, well, once again, there's a reason some of them haven't been released. But yeah, we'll try to get to it eventually.
Do you guys ever plan on doing an Achievement Hunter podcast?
That's kind of what every Let's Play is, honestly. And then you guys get, you know, you probably get more than enough Gavin and Jack on the Rooster Teeth podcast, too.
True.
Go back where?
The podcast, Jeff. Let's listen to the question.
Hey. Thanks, first off, for making Fridays less shitty during work, especially.
You're welcome for game night.
And congratulations, Michael and Lindsay, on your engagement. And this question is to you guys. Can we expect some Jones Family Let's Plays?
We have nothing in the works at present, but, you know, we both work at Achievement Hunter, so I don't see why it's not possible. I'm not gonna play Fog.
Yeah. Well, actually, people have been asking because I know we played Shadows of the Damned a little bit on Michael's channel, and then it just kind of stopped, you know, because of we're busy ass people.
Because I'm fucking lazy. That's why. We gotta do fucking 85 Let's Plays at work.
I was trying to say that nicely, but yeah, we're lazy. But I don't know. Maybe we'll do that again. It was pretty fun. Check out Garcia again, Mr. Hotspur.
Let's get married.
I'm always trying to get Lindsay to sit in to be on Let's Plays, and she always comes up with some last minute excuse why she can't do it, like she's working or she's got to edit.
And sorry.
So hey, over which way? This over here? Or did you, oh yeah, one last question. Okay. Yeah,
this is in honor of your Mad Crowd Letters. This is for you guys. So can I come up and give this to you?
Yeah, sure. Thanks.
Okay.
We're gonna kill each other with those things.
Oh shit. Gavin, you're gonna get whacked with that so many times at the office.
I like that you give the sword to the one person at the table.
Don't point
who cannot
at me, please.
Have a sword.
Dude. To see the dramatic conclusion, tune into AWU on Monday.
I'm gonna take that away from you later.
Good morning, Achievement Hunter and community.
Hello.
Good morning.
Hola. Because I'm Puerto Rican, it's a Spanish joke.
One is, are there any plans to add to the regular lineup for the Let's Play channel? And for the community, I'm looking for a young girl with a blue skirt. Has anyone seen her? No? Let me know.
This took a creepy turn.
Yeah.
If you are that girl, don't get up.
If you're a young girl in a blue skirt, I would recommend leaving right now. Are there any plans to add anything to the lineup, like the weekly lineup? I'd like to get to having a Let's Play in addition to Let's Build on Tuesdays and a Let's Play in addition to Versus on Thursdays, but I just don't know that it's physically possible right now. Yeah, and we'd have to hire more people, and I don't know where we would put them. Probably one of those dudes. Oh yeah, we gotta hire Dylan or he's gonna murder us.
Okay. Hello everyone. So I have a question. So you guys talk about how you guys, you know, have a few drinks on the Let's Plays and stuff, except for you, right? And just wanna know, how wasted do you guys get in a Let's Play?
Smashed!
Well, first off, stay in school, eat your vegetables, drink responsibly.
I've had to stop drinking during the recordings, ever since the second Minecraft video.
I remember it all too well, Gavin.
Like, I feel like my job is to kind of stir up the peace when everything's going too well. But that one was a nightmare. I had to edit that one afterwards. God damn. I just wanted to throw my headphones off. I was just listening to myself.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot cut out of that Gavin probably saved himself, but I don't know if I've ever been as mad at you than I was when recording that.
Jack stormed out.
I was so pissed off. I left the room. I literally walked outside for a good probably 15 minutes or so.
Well, that just seems
but
absurd,
then again,
Jack.
That's where the Tower of Pimps came from, was that episode. So maybe getting you drunk is, maybe it's not a bad idea. So.
Gavin, that's like your drunken Frankenstein.
Also, a ton of stuff has to get bleeped when we're drunk. Jeff could tell you all about it.
Sorry, I was playing on my phone. What's up? Oh yeah, stuff gets bleeped a lot. Usually because we're drunk.
Somewhat of an elephant in the room. What's your guy's favorite ship? Or we have Mavin fans, or...
This one right here. Right here.
All I can say is, fuck yeah, Michael Gavin. So.
Well, I have my little Minecraft diamond pendant on right here. Gavin?
Hold on a second, I gotta get my glove off.
Oh, okay, take his glove off. Gavin is like dual duoing here. He's got X-Ray and Vav and Team Nice Dynamite in effect simultaneously, so. Team lads.
I mean, Mavin is just a classic. You can't go wrong with it.
I mean, I can't count the number of times I've come into the office and found these two spooning on the couch.
In all
touching
honesty,
necklaces.
You see what makes it into the videos. It gets pretty weird sometimes.
It's the R&R connection, man.
Jack and Jeff. Yeah.
What's shipping, by the way? I don't even know.
Oh, dude, we'll talk about it later.
Okay.
I'll tell you after.
It's like FedEx?
No, it's not.
All right, so I was just curious. Ryan, I know you said you did video editing, and suddenly you appeared in Achievement Hunter. What did you bring to the table? Yeah.
What did I bring?
Yeah, what did you bring to the table?
He had a Steam account.
I knew how to operate a PC.
I was actually originally hired because Jeff had all these crazy ideas all the time and didn't have time to do them. So Game Fails being the first of those. Video editing was pretty much what I was hired for. It just turned out that I had the animation stuff too, so I got sucked away for RVB season 10.
Yeah, Ryan's the one of us that's actually talented.
It's nice having like the resident smart guy, especially like because he does all the PC stuff. We're just like, Ryan, make it work.
It's true.
All right, everybody in the community has their favorite quote from you guys. What's your favorite?
Jack.
I think my favorite quote is probably, "Surprise, motherfucker!" Followed by a drop.
I'd probably have to go with Let's Play. That's my voice is shot, I can't do it. I could try to do it. Remember when my voice was gone? You can hear it now. I'm sorry, ahead of time. Ooh, Let's Play!
I'd probably just go with, tease it.
I would say my favorite quote is the beginning of any, it says, would you rather?
I don't know, I have the short-term memory of a goldfish, so, Edgar!
Ryan doesn't watch any of our content either.
No. No.
One of my favorites that Gavin and I talk about a lot in the office is from the GTA Let's Fail during our amazing fire hydrant discussion about whether you do pop or not pop a hydrant. And he was discussing the loss of water. So I all the time, I'll go, what about all the water?
I don't think I have a favorite overall, but the one that comes to mind most recently is, bitches ain't shit, I guess. whenever the two dump trucks are careening off the top of the building in the middle of Cops and Crooks, and Gavin just goes, it's just like speed!
What is game night?
Sorry. Hello. Oh, God, now I know how Gavin feels on the podcast. I'm just gonna... Okay, better. I've been dared to ask this. Boxers, briefs, or thongs?
I hope no one says thongs, for the love of God.
I'm wearing a cup.
I'll have to go cock sock, actually.
Should we get that into the mic? You want to do that again?
Alright, next question.
My question is, what is the game that you most regret having to get all the achievements in?
Fucking Peggle.
I played Ratatouille for a website I was writing for, and it was one of those games where the achievements were pretty difficult, but I wanted to know I never had to touch the game ever again in my life. It was that bad. So I went through and perfected it.
You didn't have to touch it in the first place.
Mine was probably Borderland 1, because the Mad Moxie DLC made me want to shoot myself in the fucking face doing those larger arenas, and it took like 4 hours each time, so I was pretty fucking happy to be done with that.
Black Ops 1 and 2, because the Easter eggs take too long, and you're just done, and that's it. Like, there's no good payoff. It's like, oh, I just spent 3 hours doing this, thanks.
Welcome to achievements.
Yes, sure.
Disney's Bolt. I missed a collectible playing through it and had to go back and find it. Way too much time in that game.
I'm surprised you didn't say Assassin's Creed 3, especially since you had to do it again and re-hunt all the animals in each individual region, which was a while. But not technically achievements, but Tiny Wings for me. I probably burned like weeks of my life off on that. But I have every achievement in Tiny Wings. Hell yeah.
I remember doing the first Crackdown game with Jeff. I was helping him get the the racing achievement where you had to win every race. So what Jeff would do, he would drive around the track, and I would take a different car and drive the opposite way around the track and just throw all the other cars into the ocean and like to help him win and stuff. And all he would have to do was literally just finish the race on his own. And that took a lot of time. But there was one time where I just finished clearing out all the cars, and all I could hear, this is when I was in England and he was still in the US, so all I could hear down the Xbox Live mic was and I was like, Jeff? So I walked around the track and I just saw his car just pulled up to the side of the road, just leaning on a post, just sat there. So because it's cracked down, I picked up his car and just ran all the way around the track. It took me like 20 minutes. But hey, we got you the achievement, buddy.
I 100%ed that game.
Yeah, you did.
Okay, first of all, because of the shirt, Free Edgar, 2003. I mean, 2013, whatever. All right.
Its time has come.
Yes. And my question for y'all,
you know, you
is...
got someone behind you, right?
Oh, God. Okay. All right. Okay. So, did y'all ever... What the hell?
That's terrifying.
Yes, it is. Okay, but when y'all were creating Achievement Hunter, did y'all ever expect to have these fangirls kind of going after you sometimes?
What's gonna be?
Wait, what?
When the hell did that happen?
We have fangirls? What are you talking about?
Oh, you're talking about Gavin and Ray. They're not girls. I understand the confusion. All right, sure. You guys saw the Let's Play yesterday, right? It's not King Jeff anymore.
All hail the Mad King.
Some dark Ryan Baratheon, shit, Ryan. Everybody.
Mad King Ryan.
So I guess this is a pretty good question since Bernie was in here recently. I don't know if he's anywhere near here, but I was curious what your guys' like budget for games are, because I know that sometimes when a Versus comes out, like you'll have to go and buy a couple new games. So is that like out of pocket, or does like Bernie and Matt walk in and give you money and say, this is your money for video games?
How much do we spend on Fishing Frenzy 2010?
I'm gonna answer this question based on whether they're actually in the room or not. All right, it sounds like it's whatever the fuck I want it to be. I could buy like five video games a day every day, and it wouldn't be as much in a year as one fucking server that Gus buys. So yeah, usually there's no limit.
Plus, you've seen the games we played recently, right? Like Rapala Fishing isn't really a high ticket item.
No, yeah. So like Lindsay said, that came out of pocket, Jeff. Even, I made sure to go under the radar and get Rapala 2010.
Did they pay you to take it out of the store?
Yeah. Well, to be fair, I sent Lindsay and she did it.
It was $45.
On that note, the next Versus challenge I get is going to be in Orlando. Touché.
Why?
I'm kind of mesmerized.
Just start screaming.
I think
we've only
got
10 minutes left. We could close it out this way if you guys want to.
I feel like...
It's the most
like
profound question
X-ray
of the day,
and
I think.
Mavs should take care of this or something. They're the fucking superheroes over there. Just...
You realize I don't have any superpowers. You realize that, right?
Oh, yeah.
You got this.
Yeah, you do. You can get blown over by a strong wind. Yeah.
You've got the power of a testicle.
I got out of breath running to the stage. It's a long distance. I got like halfway home. I had to take a break. I'm like,
whew. All right, so next question over here.
You'll get your 50 bucks after the show.
First off, fuck you guys.
Yeah, man, cool.
Yeah. So hopefully that gets me a job also with Dylan. But my real question, I guess, is what are all of your full names, like middle names? I don't know if you've said that in videos.
Would you?
I don't watch any of your videos, but.
Do you need our date of birth and social security number as well?
Yeah, that would be nice too. So
mother's maiden name?
Just give me your passwords and stuff. That'd be great.
What are your fucking full names?
Ray Narvaez Jr. My dad's name is Ray, just in case anybody was wondering. I know some people don't know that.
Could your family not afford middle names?
Dude, it's fucking expensive.
Saw that coming.
Gavin David Free.
There you go.
I'm Jack Shannon Patillo.
Shannon!
That's a family name.
That's the best question of the day.
So I'm,
I had no idea.
Laugh all you want. I'm not embarrassed by that. Shannons have run through my family for years.
No, yeah, sure, Shannon. Shando.
Calm down, Fink.
Shanana. Jeffrey Laser Ramsey. Shannon.
Here comes a twist,
Ryan. I
want
to follow that. James Ryan Haywood.
Oh, they know.
Caleb Thomas Denicor.
Michael Vincent Jones.
Lindsay Elise Tuggy.
Hey, Caleb, if I paid for it, would you change your name to be Caleb Frisbee Denicor?
I don't think Whammo Corporation would allow that.
Caleb Ultimate Denicor? That's a good name.
I don't know how Jordan would feel about that.
I had a drill sergeant in the Army one time. I'm going to tell a story. She was very nice. Got kicked out of the Army for inappropriate behavior, actually, later. But I won't say what her last name was, but she was super patriotic, so she changed her name as Angie, and she changed her last name to America so she could be Miss America. And she was Sergeant America as well. Yeah, there you go.
So now that you guys have the costumes, is there going to be like an X-Rain Fab movie or short?
Yeah, what's in the works, guys?
Michael Bay is directing it, right?
Yeah. Really, what crime could they stop? Caleb had a great suggestion. They can stop the crime of screen peeking.
He's a dirty little cheater.
Sorry. I was going to say, Mr. Jordan from Anime Adventures is right in front of me. Hey, what's up? as far as X-Ray and Bav goes, we might have something that we've planned together, so there you go. Oh, sorry. Also go to the Anime Adventure panel if you want to check it out. There will be a sneak preview. Ooh.
Hello. Done good.
Oh, do you guys ever plan to bring back Force Enjoyment or Real Life Achievements?
Man, we filmed a bunch of Real Life Achievements that we never put out. I don't even know what happened to those.
I think there was one where I tried to get you to use an entire can of shaving foam at once to shave with.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Might put that out one day.
Wasn't there one where you maybe put a bunch of stuff in my mouth too?
Go on.
It wasn't dicks.
That one probably won't come out.
I watched the one where Gavin filmed you try to like wrap your lips around the faucet and like turn the water on and how long you could take it. And you went a few seconds and then just spit water everywhere and you're like, it's harder than I thought.
I don't know whatever happened to that. That wasn't that long ago.
There's a lot of I made you put the hose in your mouth and try and hold it for 30 seconds.
Yeah.
But all it was is your cheeks were puffing up and your eyes were just going like
I will say that at home, Gavin and Griffin and I film, I'd say 5 or 6 videos a week that are never intended to be seen by anybody. We just do it for fun.
It's a lot of fun.
Yeah, it is. Also, so much more gets filmed than we ever show you guys.
Yeah, as far as forced enjoyment goes, probably not. I mean, like, forced enjoyment is kind of like negative towards the game a lot, and we don't like doing that really. We like, you know, playing games and having fun, so we don't like ripping into games.
It's also kind of a rage quit.
Yeah.
Honestly, same thing. Wait, can I say something else? You guys heard that one? You should check it out. It's a good show.
Hello. Wait, can I say something else? Will it let me say something else? Hello. Hello. Oh, also Joel number one, Jack's mouse.
Hi, everyone. I am a late achievement hunter bloomer. I just discovered...
So is Gavin.
I discovered achievement hunter in December on my six-month deployment. So I want to thank you guys for making that 172 days worthwhile.
Where were you deployed to?
I was deployed flying over Afghanistan.
Well, thank you for keeping us safe. I'm gonna get uncharacteristically serious for a second and say that that means a lot to me because I was deployed to Kuwait for a year and this was pre everybody having a laptop and a fucking iPod and we just had a VHS player and the Terminator. And I had to watch that movie for a year. There was nothing else for me to do. It was the most boring year of my life. So I'm glad that we can help lessen the boredom in some way.
And I guess I'm going to do the creepy fangirl question. And I'm going to ask Gavin, hey, would you like to get some coffee with me later?
Yes.
Can you wear the suit?
Yeah, I'm going to
be
wearing this.
I'll be your Lois Lane, I promise.
All right, there we go.
Whoa!
Gavin, that's probably the best offer you're going to get today.
I warn you now, face-to-face, very underwhelming.
And that's really just all codpiece down there.
Yeah. That's where he keeps his wallet. Would you also like to go on a date with Gavin, or?
Let's all go.
If you guys ask nicely enough, I bet he'll buy you all drinks.
Well, just a quick question. With the future Let's Plays you've been talking about, would there possibly be this Volume 2 of Assassin's Creed 3?
It's funny you mention that, because we literally just recorded that, like, 3 or 4 days ago. Yeah.
So you can expect to see it in November.
Speaking of that, we're actually, so I don't know if you guys know, but after this panel at 11:30, we're playing Assassin's Creed 4 on the center stage downstairs. So, yeah, so come by, check that out. Then thank you to Ubisoft for hooking us up with that.
Yeah.
Hey, so I was wondering, what would be, like, your best Let's Play that you've played? Like, what is the most fun you've ever had playing one of them? Like, what game and what, like, what was it?
GTA 4 Cops and Crooks Part... No! Actually, it hasn't come out yet. GTA 4 co-op.
Oh my god!
Hands down, the most fun I've ever had in that room. It was.
It was me and you, Ryan, Gavin.
Yeah. So that'll come out next week, maybe or
soon.
Monday. Part one is Monday.
That.
Yeah.
Dude, I can honestly say in that video, I can't remember. Was it the first game or the second game?
It's like, what's that?
The first game or the second game? Like
For
the room.
It's the second game.
The first like 5 minutes. Of the second co-op mission we do is by far the funniest moments I've ever seen in that office.
Gavin,
we said it in the video, and I don't know if you filmed any of it. I had tears in my eyes. I was crying. I could not breathe. So, you know, Monday.
Now we built it up a lot.
Yeah.
I need to go edit some more.
My favorite games to play is definitely...
That wasn't you.
Well, that wasn't me. Was definitely any time we've played Worms.
Yeah.
Lads Part 2 coming, you know, soon, when there's space for it.
Man, the Cops and Crooks Let's Play, where those dump trucks come sailing off the bridge. We rounded that corner, and it was like an action movie. It was amazing. So that was great. And then Jeff and I getting annihilated in that car when the cops pulled up. Just gangland style. Anyone else? No? Just going to agree, so yeah. All right. Where are we at? Over here, I think, right?
My question is to all of you.
You know how you have the Minecraft Let's Plays in Achievement City? My question is, when the Xbox One comes out, are you guys going to completely rebuild everything in Achievement World, or is it just going to be Achievement City and start over?
Fuck that. Well, there are. I think 4J and Microsoft are trying to work out a way to port 360 saves over to the One. So if that's the case, yes, we'll port to the One. If not, we'll stay in the 360 for Minecraft until we fill the world, and then we'll start over again. We won't rebuild anything.
Unless someone wants to build it block for block and send it to us, that'd be top.
Yeah. It's too much fucking work. Yes. Next question.
All right. Hi. First, I want to thank you guys for bringing a lot of entertainment into my very boring life. And... secondly, this is a question for Ryan. What was the motivation behind you building the Good Vibrations thing and building it into Gavin's desk?
Well, to be fair, Gavin was the target because Gavin's desk was already torn up, and I needed one that I could shred further. So that's why it was Gavin. There was no particular malice against him. And then I had this 3D printer, and I needed to do something with it. And actually... I built that device because I was trying to build another device that I haven't done anything with yet, and I had leftover parts.
Do you have a fucking lab in the studio? Like, do you go down to your fucking tinker station?
You're a lunatic.
Now he literally has the printer at his fucking desk.
I do, yeah.
And that box sat in Gavin's desk for like 2 weeks before we turned it on, right?
It was there for a couple days, yeah. I had it ready to go one time, and then it shorted out right as we tried to initiate the Gavin annoyance plan. And then, so that's why if you look in the video, you'll see like a couple things changed on it when it actually came out of the desk. It finally worked, more or less. Gavin started banging on the desk and actually shorted it out to make it run faster. So it started off as a long delay between vibrations, and by the end of it, it was just like, meh, meh.
As soon as I found out that everyone was screwing with me, because everyone was just making like really passive comments, like Michael would turn around and be like, what was that? So immediately, I tried to find a hammer. Like, that was the first thing I wanted to do. I was just walking all around the studio looking for hammers. Didn't find one, though.
Yeah, I don't think the video captured how quickly you just descended into just a raving lunatic. It was pretty funny to watch.
All right, so unfortunately, this is going to be the last question. So last question right here.
Don't suck.
Hello? Jeff, you're my favorite.
Right answer.
He said don't suck.
Jack, will you do the truffle shuffle?
Woo! Yes! Yes! Come on, that's the best question asked!
Is that a no?
Fuck you! This camera, the camera's
come on,
closer.
Jack.
Jesus Christ. Jack. Jack.
Yeah!
Jack.
Jack.
Jack! 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 Oh. Oh.
Thank you, everyone, for coming out.
Thank you for
another
2013
panel. Go to the Assassin's Creed 4 Let's Play right now. See you next year.
Good. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for attending. Yeah. Attending the Achievement Hunter panel. If you would, please exit to your left. The far doors on the other side. I've got business the other way. So out those doors on the far side.